So without further ado, let's talk about the work program here. Our goal is to make sure that when you graduate, you are as prepared for engaging in a meaningful career, being able to go out into the world and engage and do some really great things. Our mission statement speaks to that right here. So we are providing learning opportunities that are focused on student-centered experience and career preparation, heavy focus on the career preparation. All placements will engage students in meaningful work supported by mentors. Those will be your supervisors. Opportunities to develop transferable skills will integrate with academics and community engagement through which students will develop a sense of belonging to the broader community, shaping their civic identity. I take a lot of value in the sense of belonging that work program affords you in your immediate community, the community that is your campus community. And through those lessons that you learn from the work and the mistakes that you make at work and the lessons that you learn from making those mistakes, it develops into a really bold understanding of what it means to take that yourself out into the broader community. For right now, last fall and spring, this is for last year's data because we're not quite done with this year. We had 573 student workers in the fall, 516 in the spring. Anticipate about that same for this next year. Crews in the fall, we had 68 crews and 70 in the spring. Total hours worked, 96,000 hours worked by students in the fall and 88,000 worked in the spring, which is pretty impressive when you think about that. We've got six main areas of work. These are the focus, the areas that your crew would fall under. So that is academic, administrative, and office, campus programming, craft, facilities, campus support, land management. Not all those are equally divided or evenly divided with numbers of crews or numbers of students, but they are the general areas by which our crews break up into. So right now, we've got Alisa and Tristan that are on the genetics crew. That would be an academic crew, obviously. And Matt and Reed are on spiritual life, which is a campus programming crew. So we get a little bit of opportunity to look into some of those different areas of work later. So discuss some learning outcomes. All good work should have learning with it. And if it's done right, you'll learn a bunch. We have some guided programmatic learning outcomes. And these four, these top four right here, are the our program learning outcomes. These are four learning outcomes or competencies, if you will, that employers, thousands of employers have raised up as being the top four competencies that they're looking for in graduates when they leave college and they come out to them. As I often say, if you're gonna go work at a biotech lab, managers would rather know that you're able to work well with others, that you're able to have good communication skills, and think critically and problem solve. They can teach you the technical aspects of working in a biotech lab. Of course, they'd love you to have some of those skills when you come to them. But these are the things that they are seeing, that employers are seeing, that are not, they're not able to necessarily coach in recent grads as much as they would like to have them come with. So professionalism, teamwork, collaboration, critical thinking and problem solving, and communication are our four. Every crew's got some crew-specific outcomes. These are determined by the work of the crew. These are determined by the position descriptions. Every position that you have at Warren Wilson College will have a position description associated with it that will have the learning outcomes. It'll have the general description of what you're going to be doing. So you'll have that kind of guided specific outcomes through that experience. And these will actually develop with you as you matriculate through the program. So as you're moving through the program, as you're matriculating on a crew, you will ascend into different positions with more a greater variety of tasks at hand, of opportunities to accept a leadership role, and with that are going to come different outcomes that come along with that. So what your first steps in the program will be when you are ready to jump on board and get into things at the beginning of summer. One of the first things you're going to be doing this with the work program is going through our hiring process. And this is for all incoming students. We will have all the open job descriptions posted online. You will have access to all of those. You'll be able to peruse all those. You'll be able to read all the job descriptions, look at those learning outcomes, look at those general duties and see what you're excited about doing. And thinking through what you're interested in doing, how you might want to align it with your academics. If you've got a strong mind for where you want to go with your community engagement, think about your work experience marrying up with that as well. And as we'll talk about later, they don't always have to marry up, but that is a great opportunity to integrate from the very beginning. So you're going to go through a common application process. You're going to fill out an application for crews that you're excited about. We're going to recommend that you apply to two or three, if not a few more than that, just to make sure that we get an opportunity to get you hired and placed on a crew. Your application is going to be sent off to the supervisors of those crews. We're going to give you an opportunity to upload a resume or to answer some questions about what competencies you bring, what experience you bring, things we need to know about you as a worker. Those supervisors are going to read that information, assessing whether or not your skills that you bring or your interests that you bring will work well with the work of the crew. And then if they will be reaching out to you if they want to schedule any further interview opportunities. Maybe that's an email interview or a phone interview or a Zoom, a virtual face-to-face interview while you're not on campus yet. Supervisors are then going to send their recommendation list to us in the work program office, the WPO for short. We're going to then send out offer letters to you based on what crews you were accepted to or those offers that you were given. And then you're going to come tell us, respond whether you accept or decline those offers. So if you are applying to three crews and you're accepted or an offer is extended for all three of those crews, you get to pick which of those crews you're going to be on. And if you're rejected to one but accepted to the other two, then you'll have the opportunity to figure out which one you want to take.